Did you know that on the moon, you weigh just 20% of what you weigh on Earth? So I weigh about 200 pounds. That means on the moon, I'm gonna weigh just 40. It means you can jump way higher. That force from gravity holding you down is just less, and so you can jump way higher. For example, a world-class basketball player can jump like 40 inches. On the moon, they would be able to jump 18 feet. That's a slam dunk. That's what I'm talking about. It all has to do with weight and mass. Mass is a measure of how much stuff is there, and that doesn't change, but weight is a force due to gravity. And because the moon is smaller, that force is smaller. Let's learn about weight and mass. Let's start by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, we'll contrast weight and mass. Then, we'll calculate weight using Newton's second law. It turns out that weight, because it's a force, can be calculated with Newton's second law. And lastly, we'll learn to convert between newtons and pounds. Remember that newtons is what we call the SI unit for force. It's the normal unit we use for force, but pounds is also a unit for force. And so we'll learn to go back and forth between those two. This astronaut is hovering through the middle of their spacecraft. Out deep in space, the gravitational force is basically zero. This means that his weight is zero. Weight, remember, is a force due to gravity. And without gravity, you become weightless. However, the astronaut still has a mass. If she wants to accelerate, that is, to turn, slow down, or speed up, she still needs to exert a force. Let's review exactly what mass is. Mass, remember, is a measure of the total matter present. And mass doesn't change no matter where you are. So even though the space shuttle is farther away from the surface of the Earth, and the gravitational acceleration is reduced because of that, though, just to be clear, the gravitational acceleration of Earth isn't zero just because you suddenly are in space. You still get drawn towards the Earth. Weight, though, weight does change. It's a force due to the acceleration of gravity. And so, as we mentioned in the introduction, weight does change when you're on the moon. Maybe this astronaut weighs just 30 pounds. And now we know that they're actually not jumping very high. They could do much, much better. All right, let's think about weight and mass in light of Newton's second law. Remember that Newton's second law tells us that the net force is equal to mass times acceleration. So the acceleration an object experiences is equal to the net force when you multiply it by mass. Okay, where does weight go? Well, weight is a force, so it goes over here on the force side. And so what we're actually going to do is just change that force there to W. Weight is equal to mass times acceleration. And mass just goes on that M side. So notice that mass goes on one side of Newton's second law, whereas weight goes on the other. So you can see now how different they are. When we are solving for weight, that acceleration is the acceleration due to gravity. That's very specifically what weight means. It's the force due to gravity. And so we can substitute that A for a G, where that little g means the acceleration due to gravity. Okay, now we're going to launch into a number of problems where we use weight is equal to mass times gravity. This problem says, in the depths of space, the acceleration due to gravity is zero. What is the weight of a 2,000 kilogram spaceship? All right, this is probably going to be one of the easiest problems we do. The only thing we got to get right is distinguishing mass and weight. So let's list our knowns. What do we know? Well, we know that our mass is 2,000 kilograms. We know one other thing, and that is that the acceleration due to gravity out in the middle of space is zero. Okay, that's a pretty small acceleration. Now all we gotta do is solve for weight. Weight is equal to mass times gravity. All right, that acceleration due to gravity there. So weight is equal to 2,000 kilograms times our acceleration of zero, which is equal to zero. Okay, exactly what you expect. You're weightless in the depths of space if the gravity is zero. No problems there. Let's go ahead and take a look then at a slightly harder problem. The average human has a mass of around 65 kilograms. Given that the acceleration due to Earth's gravity is 9.8 meters per second squared. What is the weight of the average human? So here we're going to solve for the weight of the average human. All right, let's do it. What do we know? We know the mass. That is not the weight, right? Those are two different things. That's what we've been learning. And it's 65 kilograms. The acceleration due to gravity on Earth is 9.8 meters per second squared. And we want to know the weight. That is our unknown. So we're going to write weight is equal to mass times gravity. And in this case, our mass is 65 and our gravity is 9.8. This is going to give us 637. Quick question, what are the units here? If you guessed newtons, you're exactly right. Remember that when we do kilograms times meters per second squared, we're always going to get newtons. Lastly, we want to round this for sig figs. Notice that our acceleration has two sig figs, and so does our mass. And so when we round this for sig figs, we're going to get 640 newtons. So that is the weight of the average person in newtons. You're used to seeing it in pounds, and in just a second, we'll actually take a look at what these weights are like in pounds. Okay, here we go. Convert 640 newtons into pounds. So we're going to start with that answer that we got for our last problem, 640 newtons. And we just want to do a conversion. Now, we've reviewed conversions in this class before, but let's just take one more look at them. 640 newtons, and we want to go to pounds. So whenever we do a conversion, we'll write what we're starting with, and we'll write the units we want to go to. Over here, we want to get to pounds. Okay, got it. Now, let's go ahead, and let's fill in our conversion factor. We know that we want to get rid of newtons, so newtons is going to go on the bottom, and we want to go to pounds, so pounds is going to go up top. We're told that 4.45 newtons is 1 pound. So 4.45 goes with newtons because that's what it was with up in our conversion factor. And 1 goes with our pounds. When we divide 640 by 4.45, we're going to get 140 pounds after rounding to 2 sig figs. So that means the average person's weight in pounds is about 140. That's the sort of unit you're used to seeing. Let's keep going. What else do we got? This one says on the moon, the acceleration due to gravity is just 1.6 meters per second squared. What is the weight in pounds of a 65 kilogram human on the moon? Great question. All right, so let's go ahead and start by listing what we know. We know that the acceleration on the moon due to gravity is 1.6 meters per second squared. Awesome. What is the weight in pounds of a 65 kilogram human? So we again have our mass as 65 kilograms. And we want to know that on the moon. And lastly, we want to know that weight in pounds. So we're looking for weight, and we want to get that into the units of pounds, because that's frankly the unit we're most comfortable thinking about weight in usually. Okay, so we're going to once again use our weight equals mass times gravity equation. And here we're going to plug in for mass our 65 kilograms, no surprises, and our 1.6 for our gravity in this case. When we multiply those two together, we're going to get 104 newtons. Now, we're not going to round that number yet because we haven't converted yet. So generally, just as a good rule, when you're working a problem, don't round till the very end. This is going to become very important in some later units. Now, we're going to go ahead and convert that to pounds. So we'll go ahead and put our newtons on the bottom and our pounds up top, just like we did before. 1 pound and 4.45 newtons. So we divide 104 newtons by 4.45, and we're going to get 23.37 dot, 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 and on it goes. We're going to round that to 2 sig figs, again, because our mass has 1.2 and our acceleration has 1.2. So when we round that to 2 sig figs, we'll keep the first 2 and the first 3. And this 3 right here tells us that we're going to round down, so we'll get 23 newtons. Oh, not newtons. That's wrong. Did you catch it? Because if you did, great job. It's now in pounds, right? Our newtons have canceled out. Get rid of those newtons right there, and we have pounds. So on the moon, the average human weighs 23 pounds. Let's summarize what we've learned. First, we contrasted weight and mass. We saw that weight is a force that we can calculate when we multiply mass times the gravitational acceleration. We calculated weight using Newton's second law, And then we learn to convert between newtons and pounds, two different ways to measure force. Hey, hey.